Hello student, myself Professor Gada Kisses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yeovil. Student, we are learning the final year subject that is nothing but solar and wind energy. Since from last so many lectures, we have seen too many topics from unit number 1 to unit number 5. Basically, first 4 units are related to the solar energy, then last unit number 5 and unit number 6 is related to the wind energy and biomass energy. So, some topics we have seen from the wind energy and biomass energy up to the last lecture. So, those students have not seen that videos, you can see that videos from our YouTube channel. Now, in the today's lecture, we are going to see one of the next topic, that is nothing but the biomass as a source of energy and conversion of biomass into the suitable form. So, different types of conversion processes are there for converting the biomass into the suitable form of the energy. So, that processes also we are going to see in the today's lecture. So, up to the last lecture, we have seen the biomass is as a source of energy. So, what is the biomass and which are the types of biomass, that also we have seen in the last lecture. So, three types of biomass we have seen. That's are nothing but woody biomass, animal waste, and another one is nothing but the different types of biomass. So, that biomass we have seen and along with its applications also. So, in the today's lecture, we are going to see how that biomass will converted into the suitable form of energy. So, for that, different conversion processes are there, that also we are going to see. So, let's start the conversion of biomass into the suitable form. So, some biomass types like the fuel wood can be used directly for generating the energy. That means fuel wood. Fuel wood means what? We will directly use it for the generating the energy. That means we are directly burning that wood fuel and from that we are boiling the water and deriving the mechanical or electrical energy. But what happen in some of the biomass energy, we can not directly derive that energy into the useful form of energy. So for that we have to do some conversion processes. So what they have said, but most of the biomass types require some modifications, that is conversion from one form to the another form. Before extracting the useful energy from it, the conversion of form is required for many reasons. Now, why that conversions are required, that we are going to see first and then we will see the different conversion processes. So, let's see how many or which are the reasons due to which we have to convert that one form of biomass into the another form. So, first reason is that the moisture content inhibits the easy conversion and also results in the energy losses. That means what? Some of the biomass are there, that means animal dungs. So, if there is a moisture content, at that time we are not directly able to use that. So, that will also cause the power energy loss. So, for that purpose, we have to make the drying of it. Also, for the wood fuel, we have to dry the wood fuel so that we will derive the maximum energy that from that fuel. All of you understand? So, drying or reduction of moisture content before use increases its energy value. And that is the reason due to which we have to do some processes or conversion of biomass into the another form. Next reason due to which we have to convert one form of biomass into the another, that is nothing but biomass types that usually does not have a homogeneous form causes difficulty in the handling, pumping and transporting systems. So, that's are the three difficulties we will achieve when there is a does not homogeneous form. Okay, so converting biomass into the fluid like the liquid or gas improves its handling characteristics. All of you understand that? That means what? Converting the biomass into the fluid like the liquid or gas improves its handling characteristics. So that's are the some reason due to which we have to convert one form of biomass into the another form, or we have to do some processing on the raw biomass before using it into the practical applications. So let's see the types of conversion processes. That means we have seen why we have to convert one form of biomass into another form. Now there are some conversion processes are there. So basically three types of conversion processes are there: thermochemical process, biochemical process, and last one mechanical process. So we are going to see that into the details. So types of conversion processes. It is stated in the above paragraph that the biomass needs to be converted into the appropriate form in order to use it for the useful purposes that we have already seen. There is a wide variety of form in which biomass is available. Therefore, there are number of processes by which biomass is converted to the suitable form. For instant conversion of biomass into the gaseous form, that is the biogas product or biogas plant, conversion into the liquid form, that is the ethanol, conversion into the solid form, that is nothing but the charcoal, following processes are commonly used. That means for conversion, we are using the following processes. So first process we are going to see, that is nothing but the thermochemical process. So let's see what happened into the thermochemical process, or what we are going to achieve with the help of thermochemical process. So for thermochemical process, they have stated that in this process, heat is provided to the biomass in order to change its chemical composition. That means we are going to heat up the raw biomass into the thermochemical process. And why we are doing that? To change the chemical composition of the raw biomass. Using this process, biomass can be converted to the charcoal or producer gas. Thus, the process flows look like. So biomass, we are adding the energy, thermal energy, that is the thermal energy input, and at the last we will get the charcoal or producer gas. The temperature range in which the conversion process occurs can vary from few hundred to the several hundred degree centigrade. That means from smaller temperature to higher temperature we can heat up the raw biomass and we will achieve the required product. So that is nothing but the thermochemical process that is done on the raw biomass to convert or to achieve the chemical composition of the required stage. So that is nothing but the thermochemical process. Now next we are going to see the biochemical process. In short, we can say that aerobic or anaerobic process. So in the biochemical process, what happened? In this process, the change in chemical composition of biomass, so especially sugar cane, starch, etc., occurs due to the application of biological agent. That means in the biological process, we are going to add the biological agent or apply the biological agent for this process. Using this process, biomass can be converted into the biogas and ethanol. The process flow looks like biomass. On that we are going to apply biological process with or without the oxygen, and at the last we will get the biogas or ethanol. When the biochemical process takes place in the absence of oxygen, in case of the biogas production, then it is called as the anaerobic process. That means biochemical process are two types. In the absence of oxygen, it is called as an anaerobic process. And when biochemical process take place in the presence of oxygen, then it is called as an aerobic process. That means two types of biochemical processes are there: anaerobic and aerobic process. Anaerobic means without the oxygen. Anaerobic means with the application of oxygen. So that's are nothing but the biochemical process. Then last type of process, first we have seen, that is nothing but the thermochemical process. Second procedure we have seen, that is the biochemical process. And third process we are going to see for the processing on the raw biomass, that is nothing but the mechanical process. So let's see why that mechanical process is applied. So in this process, the change in chemical composition is obtained by the mechanical processing. That means mechanical processing we are going to do to change the chemical composition. Using this process, vegetable oil can be extracted from the biomass. That means that mechanical process is applied to extract the oil, to extract the vegetable oil from the biomass. Thus, the process flows looks like biomass chemical process, and at the output we will get vegetable oil. So in the today's lecture we have seen what is the biomass, or why that conversion of raw biomass into the actual biomass is required. So for that process there are three processes are there. So types of conversion of the biomass. First one is the thermochemical process, in which we are going to heat up the raw biomass to change the chemical composition. Second one is a biochemical process. So in the biochemical process, we are going to use the biological components to change the chemical composition of the materials, raw materials. So two types of biochemical processes are there: anaerobic and aerobic biochemical process. Anaerobic means in the absence of oxygen, and aerobic means the presence of oxygen the process will done. Then third process is nothing but the mechanical process. So in the mechanical process, what we are going to do, we are going to change the chemical composition by the mechanical processing. Okay, and in this process we are going to extract the vegetable oil from the biomass. So that's are the three processes for converting the biomass into the useful form of the energy. All of you understand that? So I think all of you have understand the biomass conversion into the required process. So today we will stop here for the today's lecture, and next point we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, friends.